This is Mount Hrabevich, the site of the two-man bobsled competition. Nestled in the snowy pines, it is one of three big round-shouldered hills that guards the city of Sarajevo on three sides. The track was built by an architect named Borisov Bouchard, who was concerned with, among other things, conserving the beauty of the mountain and offering the Olympians the fastest, most challenging course in the world. Its beauty remains. In fact, these wooded slopes have become the country's favorite recreation area. As for the challenge, see for yourself. It's 13 cool curves that tormented the drivers all week during practice. There have been crashes at Hrabevich on a course which requires the touch of a surgeon to negotiate the tight turns. It takes the nerve of a thrill seeker to conquer this mountain. Even Ralph Pichler, the Swiss world champion, in his first practice run, lost control. Pichler, driving a new sled he couldn't control. A spectacular crash. They pushed these sleds to the edge of control at speeds of nearly 80 miles per hour in an effort to beat the clock. Bobsledders, unique indeed. They come from three continents, Asia, Europe, and North America, from the Eastern Bloc countries in the West, all for the chance to rattle down that icy road in a record time in an effort to win the gold. Hello, everybody. I'm Tim Brandt, and we'll be announcing the two-man bobsled competition today and tomorrow. Then next week, February 17th and 18th, Friday and Saturday, we'll have the big sleds, the four-man bob races. The heavy snow that we've experienced here on Mount Hrabevich the past 24 hours continues to fall. However, the track is in pretty good condition. It may become a factor as we get down later in the heats, though, and the snow starts to accumulate. The sport of bobsledding, it dates back to the origin of the Winter Games, 1924 in Chamonix, France, and it has been with us ever since. Bobsledding, the scoring goes like this. The final time is a combined total of four separate runs, and we have now completed the first heat. At the top of the leaderboard, the East Germans and the Soviet Union. East Germany number two, the driver is Wolfgang Huppe, his time 51.51 seconds. Number two is the Soviet Union number two. He is just 0.05 of a second off the pace, and the number three sled of the East Germans number two. My colleague for this competition is a former member of the U.S. team from Saranac Lake, New York, John Morgan. John, how has this sport changed?
To me, since the inception of this sport at the turn of the century, they labeled it then the Champagne of Thrills, and it moved along with a reputation for about five decades. And then the East Germans entered the picture in 1976. They changed it a lot then. The Soviets are here for the first time ever in 84, and they brought another new dimension to the sport. Revolutionary sleds, tremendous track and field athletes at the start, and now the sport is transcended from the Champagne of Thrills into the mixture of science and sport.
Give me a description of this course.
Here is the course, 413 feet vertical drop from top to bottom, steep by bobsled standards. Course length, 4,083 feet, 700 feet shorter than the Olympic bobsled course at Lake Placid in 1980. Now here's a diagram of the course, seven corners left, six corners right. And requirements by the FIBT, the world governing body of bobsledding the world, are an S combination at the top, curves 5, 6, and 7, a hairpin, which we call Omega, and now the labyrinths, very, very crucial. Now up to the top for a point of view of what the driver actually sees as he comes down this course. I had an opportunity to ride, and believe me, it was exciting. As he travels down, the first part of the start is 12% grade. Again, very steep by bobsled standards. Here out of curve one, the gradient changes a little bit more. A lot of speed here for out of curve one on a bobsled course. Now the gradient from curves two, three, and four, the gradient goes to about 15%. I've ridden six bobsled runs, and I've never seen so much speed at the top as here at Hrabevich. Now into curve five, four and five and six and seven, here speeds of 60 miles an hour. This is where all the accidents are happening. Here in curve six, a big transition, much like zigzag at Lake Placid. Now seven, out of seven, now the long straightaway above Omega, 70 miles an hour here. Into Omega, we have a big 200 degrees change to the left. Now curve nine, another big change to the right. Now into the labyrinth. This is the most meticulous part of the course for the drivers. They have to be very smooth here. Now we go into the finish corner. Another big sweeping change to the right. And now we're through and down. Underneath the finish bridge, an accumulation of what the bobsledders call the Champagne of Thrills.
There are 28 sleds competing for the gold medal here at Hrabevich. This is the start box you're looking at, Ralph Pichler. He is the third driver of the second heat, currently in sixth place. 29 years old, 5'11", 170 pounds. Now, he is the reigning world champion. Suffered a spectacular crash in his very first run here last Saturday. But he's changed sleds and changed brakemen. Rico Friermuth is his brakeman. Ors Luitold is the man who was usually riding with Pichler.
They didn't get a very good start in the first heat, and again, at Hrabevich, you need the good starts. The start to beat on the left will be Anton Fischer of West Germany.
6.43, Anton Fischer's time, the best of the second heat, Pichler's 6.52. As they come down the hill, now only the driver has eyes. The brakeman will tuck away for aerodynamics.
looks good so far for Pichler. Again, that start time is not the Swiss normal start time. Let's watch him here in six. Now, seven is the corner he crashed on. Let's see if he gets through seven this time.
Out of Little Lasso left, 576 meters to go as he comes down the straightaway, heading to the Omega.
33.46 at Fisher's time, 33.51. That's better for Pichler than his last heat.
200-degree turn, being hit by force four times out of gravity.
Fastest part of the course here now. This is where the driver's got to be just like a surgeon in here. Very precise.
Final curve, the time, 52.33. He needs to take the lead. His time, 52.21. He's now in first place.
I think Pichler will be happy with that. He improved his time from the first heat, and now he's in first place. But I don't think Ralph Pichler is the same Ralph Pichler that we knew from last year.
Ralph Pichler's had two accidents, John, and that will take the edge off of you mentally. This is the United States number two sled, Freddie Fritsch and Wayne DeAtley. They are in 21st place. Brent Rushlaw, the USA number one team, is in 16th place. Now, both of these sledders here are Navy SEALs. Freddie's been in the sport 11 years, competed in the 1976 Olympic Games.
Yeah, Freddie Fritsch came out of nowhere to be the number two driver in this two-man competition from the Olympic Trials in Lake Placid. Very competitive, both these guys. Wayne DeAtley is a brakeman, a tremendous basketball player. Both of them are great athletes.
20 inches of snow, 23 degrees out here. 6.43 is the best time of the day. Best time of this heat by Anton Fisher. They're 6.81. Not really that competitive, John.
No, and that and bobsledding, your start time, they're behind by 40 hundredths there. That's going to transcend to three times that at the bottom. So the start's very crucial in bobsledding. They gave up a lot at the start.
Part of the course, it gets up speed, establishes rhythm, and sets the pace.
They're driving what we call a very stock sled, not any kind of suspension on it like the East Germans. It's like a streetcar and a race car comparison. But for the split time, 33.46 is Fisher of West Germany, 34.13. He's considerably off the pace.
Through Omega, 576 meters to go for Freddie Fritsch. He is acting now solely on instinct and reflex.
Fastest part of the course down here through the labyrinth. Now they're going to the finish corner. Let's look for his time.
He needs a 50.95 to take the lead. The through and down is time, 53.32. That'll put him in eighth place. His aggregate time for the first two runs, 146.79.
He came down 15 hundredths in his first heat. That's an achievement in itself right there.
Run number two of the two-man bob competition continues right now. They're cleaning off the course. We'll be back in just a moment.